still.
There aren't many minis then, are there? They're actually small, these ones, look. There's no clubman in sight, so I'll drive them.
Too far for the live action arena. Little car, little red one with the MX5 parts. That's the first one, the Mark 1, the NA as it's known. What's really interesting about these cars is when the Japanese went to design them, what they did was very clever. They actually bought the original Lotus Elan. That's the car that they actually referenced. They actually bought one, took it apart, had a look, what made it so perfect in terms of weight distribution, balance, handling. And if you look at the lines of the original car, the NA, you can see there's a little bit of that Lotus magic in the earlier cars. The car that comes here, this beautiful burgundy car, the icon here, that's the Mark II, or the NB as it's known. Really nice development of the style, lovely looking motor car. Some ways dynamically better, a little bit bigger inside, which is good if you're as big as me and Chris, the cameraman here. You then go on to the NC, which is this car here, this very, very lovely one that's in front of me now, the 07 plate. That's the third generation. For me, that's the best one they did because it's the biggest one inside. Got the most leg room for big lads. Again, dynamically brilliant. What Mazda's very clever at doing with the MX-5, and it's unusual, is they've managed to keep the car.
Aspiring owner of a classic car, don't quite have the funds, budget or know-how to get into the hobby. I might be meeting a few people in a moment that might help you out. So come and join me back in 2 minutes here in the live action arena, and I'm going to be talking about the classic car loan project, what it is, who can benefit from it, and how you can get involved.
Where would you go if you got lost? You have to go to find that.
Or you go to a police coaster.
Or someone with a big orange vest on, you sound lost. Don't go out the field, you don't get lost.
Anyway, it went off for repair and this company was taking ages and ages, so he moved it to a different garage. It's quite refreshing actually, because he admits he's not a mechanic at all, he's just like, no shit.
Yeah.
And he contacted the people who used to have it, and apparently it had been in a crash and the chassis was bent, and the insurance had paid out to have the chassis bent. The company that he had put it with got the money, and so they were able to give it a proper restoration.
And is that why it had crashed? Because it was,
well,
distorted.
Not problem some stuff on the way back.
Weird.
Fiat's mini number plate.
I wonder if there's going to be any Rileys.
Thank you.
88 miles an hour.
Yeah. bit of a premium. Everybody wants one. Everybody wants to put one in their collection. The nice Capri is now easily a five-figure car. So we'll get the guys to park up in a minute.
I said, what? I think yours have one step longer, yeah? Orange fluid.
so we've got the luxurious chairs and the things here.
Did you know